Hello everybody, welcome. I'm Quasar Sudo, and welcome to a Let's Play of Star Wars Empire War, Forces of Corruption, The Reckoning Mod, Custom Campaign. This, I said I was going to get to this, and now I finally have the chance to do it. So, I'm going to play the custom opening, so we'll be back, guys.
There's some stormtroopers here wondering why I'm not loading.
That was the opening cutscene.
Better hurry up, or
so here we have Candorous,
leader of the Mandalorian.
Yeah, Mandalore, and Darth Nihilus. I guess the thing you guys have to understand is that the beginning level for the intro is going to be the same, but after this, after that point, it's the custom story. So now that we finally have, now that I've finally gotten around to doing the custom story. Now, come here, Mandalore. Bribe them! And the guy who made this mod did really well, because look, it looks just like Nihilus, frankly. You get a close-up look on him like that, it looks just like him. And the same goes for,
I'm here if you want something done
Mandalore
right.
As well. Speaking of Mandalore, which Knights of the Old Republic games were your favorite? Did you guys like one or two? And if you like one or two, actually, who was your favorite character from that? Like, okay, your favorite, who was your favorite companion and favorite villain? And oh my god, is that an AT-AT? Oh, yeah, that's right.
Come with me, man.
Silence yourself.
Consortium will rule once more.
So as you guys can notice, the CT-3 right there. You guys dead? Yep, they're dead, everybody. So, as you guys have read, Revan has returned after 3,000 years. The Republic is now fighting the Empire, and the Empire's on the verge of defeat. Well, so, then our story takes place. Give me a Stormtroopers. I don't think you know what you guys are getting into for this one, guys. I'm not really sure. I know I played the first Reckoning.
Yeah, what do you want?
Because the one I'm playing right now is actually the revised, edited with higher graphics. So,
Right.
Hey, LS, fast forward. Okay, let me go ahead and fast forward through all of this. What are you guys doing? Stop, don't stand there. Oh my god, you guys are gonna kill me. Forward! Forward, my troops! Destroy the Empire! Oh, I bribed you. Yay, for bribery! Okay, for bribery.
Wait, there are some droids
up ahead. Oh god,
Darth Troopers. I will go ahead and take them out.
Shut up!
Nonsense. Send the prisoners. It's not as if I intend to bring them with us on the ship.
I can't skip that. That's bull. But, what are you guys... If you guys have played the Old Republic,
Your
the
choice.
Forged Alliance...
I'm here if you want something.
The way they kind of have the Reckoning set up is kind of similar to how they have the Force of Iron set up when Revan returns. You see this? You see the outline skirmishes of, like, the outline, like, I guess you can see the remnants of his army? Until Revan eventually introduces himself like he did in Force of Iron. But let me know what you guys think about that, actually, because, what do you guys think about Revan returning, like, during the Clone Wars? No. What do you think he would do?
What? Moving to secondary position.
Okay, so that's the first part of this, actually.
Hold on a second. Where's my cargo?
Can't
what's with all
that,
these people?
But,
I'm not running a passenger ship.
Don't worry, guys. It's just,
cargo,
the first
Captain
level
Solo.
Is just the same.
Don't worry
as
about
the
prisoners.
The
they found
but
their
other
way
than
in
that,
here.
Else is all
they can find
content.
Their own way out. Whoa. Wait a minute.
Your man said this was just a spice run. Now, of course, I never believed that nonsense about a spice run,
Darth
but I didn't count on an Imperial prison riot.
Solo.
I'll
you can only imagine how that would actually
fee.
Go, you know?
I know, Chewie. I get the feeling we don't have much choice if we want to leave here with our skins attached. Get aboard now. We're leaving.
Because think about it, it's really
right.
Interesting,
we need to
honestly.
Establish our criminal network as
you
soon
know,
as possible.
Returns during the Old Republic,
a bounty on my
but yet he returns
bounty
again
the galaxy
during the Clone
will be out
Wars.
To stop us.
You know, let me know what you guys think about that. What do you think Revan would do if he actually returned during the end of the Clone Wars? How? Oh, they added in new characters! Yay!
It seems we have company. Commander, I was not expecting you to arrive for quite some time. I assume everything went according to plan then. Good. We can discuss your report later. There is an Imperial officer on the planet's surface that knows the location of our hidden Jedi temple on Ryloth. Strange. He has not reported this information yet to the Empire. I can't have my base compromised. Assemble a strike team. Take whoever you may need. Just see to it that he doesn't survive.
Then we will need defilers.
Okay, if you guys don't understand that part, that the guy looking like Tiber Zahn was actually supposed to be a figure of Revan speaking to you. And this new content, new ships, new units, the graphics have been redesigned. Like in this one right here, there's Mira from Knights of the Republic 2. If you guys didn't notice down here, there's Mandalore. There's Mandalore, Bastila Lashan, Juhani, Darth Nihilius, Revan, Master Vandar, and Darth Treo, along with the basic units. I have the Sith Soldiers. I have the Mandalorian Assault Team. I have Turbo Laser Towers. Actually, really cool.
Malice, your strike team's ready.
And I have Mandalorian Warriors. My defilers will go over to spread corruption to, I can't pronounce the name of the planet, but, we're gonna speed that up just a bit.
Proceed with the mission as planned.
So...
We move quickly.
Revan has returned to the Nova Universe after 3,000 years. The Republic has reinserted itself.
I have heard
and now...
Of their battle skills. So
I don't know. I'm really curious to know what happens during this custom story, everybody. Because I think it's really interesting that the person took the time to make this mod. So let's... Sorry if I'm talking so much, but I am very fascinated about this mod.
For corruption and lesson
I know other people have done... I saw someone else who did a Let's Play, actually. But the Let's Play on it was like more of a Galactic Conquest, and he didn't do the custom story to it. I'm not bad-mouthing him. His Let's Plays were good, but I wish he would have gotten around to doing the custom campaign for this. So if I remember anything correctly, then I want to move you up first, Nihilius. because getting up through that. I remember I did the first part of this Swamp during the original one.
Moving.
And I always moved to Helios first, because the Helios always had to move up and take out the little huts. Helios, why aren't you attacking? Is my button fucked up? Hold on. Can you not destroy dwellings? That is some shit.
Yes, Commander.
Fuck that.
Fire.
Nihilus! We have enemies! Steal that knife.
And trade their atoms on the dark side.
Okay.
Ready for command,
these stormtroopers? No, those are Sith soldiers. Okay. These are Mandalorians.
Target acquired. Course set.
Nihilus, are you doing okay?
Assault in progress.
Come back! I just want to be your friend! Don't run from me! I'm not really sure what to talk about during the entire thing with the bot let's play, but it's like, I don't know. I'm just so hyped up for this because someone actually did a custom mod. A custom story mod. Which is something, honestly, guys, you don't see very often for, like, Empire and War mods. Wait, no.
Support order acknowledged.
You fools! Allow me to drain your health to the dark side. Give me nourishment so I may crush you. So, I'm moving it. If you guys haven't noticed, there is custom music. The custom music files in this game are from Knights of the Old Republic, Knights of the Old Republic 2, and Republic Commando. Well, you're playing as Republic. If you guys don't realize, but.
Always ready, sir.
If you guys want me to, what I'm going to actually do is take the time and do a let's play on Revan's Alliance, like I did last time, but I will do a let's play on the Republic side to show you the Republic units and what they have, and also on probably the Empire as well. So we're already on for 13 minutes. Hold up, where the hell is this guy at? Oh! Come! Feel the wrath of the dark side. Okay, hold up. Am I missing another camp? You got
it. Changing course.
Oh, I am. I'm missing one.
Hostiles.
Fast forward! Hey, Helios, what are you doing? Why are you not doing like I told you to do? Okay, did I get this one? Is this one dead? Okay. World corrupted by Revan. And he's a knight of darkness. Fast forward to that. Force bonds. Oh, that's actually new.
The Imperial officer. I looked for his private files, and I found nothing regarding how he found the location of my base on Ryloth. Strange. I feel something else is here, but I'm just not seeing it. T3M4, start decrypting the rest of the files. While T3M4 is deciphering the data, I have a mission for you, Commander. You'll need credits in the future. The funner fleet supply upgrades. The local huts will be more than happy to depart with a couple of credits.
Use a defiler to set up a racketeering operation on Shola. Okay. So I need to build another defiler. But I'm going to speed that process up. So, if you guys haven't seen, the 4A Corvettes are actually used ground combat. And I should probably start building a fleet at some point. But, we'll get to that eventually. Okay, hold on. I need something. Okay, I need to build 3 Mandalorians. Okay. 1, 2, 3. here. Oh fuck, I need to sell a unit. Okay, hold on. I know what I need to do. Therefore, I need a third one. If you guys like this Let's Play, if you want to see more of a custom campaign, let me know. I'll be more than happy to do more. Oh my god. Rebel Blade. Okay, there we go.
Now that we have more of an income, we can focus on making ships, training new units for the upcoming battles to come.
D3! Yeah!
Reinforcement is up decrypting the data. I have found out something far more worse. It seems that the Mandalorians have supplied the Empire with the location of my base.
Oh, shit.
And that's not all. One of the Mandalorians has stolen our prototype ships. It is incomplete at the moment. I want them dealt with. Master Revan, I thought the Mandalorians were on all sides. Why would they do this? The Mandalorian Crusaders are much more different than the Mandalorians you see nowadays. Right, but why are the Mandalorians doing this? Power? Greed? Power. Honor. That's always puzzled me. What would honor truly mean if you died? It's just a puzzling question that bothers my mind from time to time. Now on to business. This man of war is part of a new clan. Contact our associate Tiberzon, then report back to me immediately.
Oh!
Yes, Lord Revan.
Ah, Tiberzon! Oh, wow. Tiberzon is Revan's contact. Use piracy to corrupt Mandalore. Okay. Let me give that a shot, actually. Piracy, let's find out. Let's see how this works. Because it seems how Revan said the Mandalorian Crusaders of this day is a lot different from the ones from his time. Which, and honestly, it's been 3,000 years, so yeah, it's probably true. Piracy. Then I'm gonna do this one more, and then I'm probably gonna...
Men? The Zahn Consortium expects your best today. If everyone does their part, we'll not fail. We'll be facing the Mandalorian clan chieftains attempting to defend the space above their planet. Their proud warrior tradition means this will be a fight to the death.
So this is Tiber Zahn's flagship. Well, Revan's flagship that Tiber Zahn is not in control of. Okay. So if I remember anything from Space Combat correctly, like any of my other ones, okay, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have my fighters go in first. I want my fighters to take out anything I don't need to worry about first. So probably gonna have them take out the shield generator first. And I want my bombers to actually target those turbo laser batteries. But yeah, I want my bombers to go for that those shield generators first. Because once my shield generator moves into like position, I'm going to actually move my capital ship into position and actually destroy it. What are you guys doing? Get back over there. What the hell are you guys doing? Stop being a douche. Here we go. Okay, the shield generator is down. Which means, okay. Actually, moving to cinematic point of view. I'd have to say that the Infinite Fleet, the Endar Spire tries Infinite Fleet song that actually... Oh shit, what the fuck is that? Oh my god, is that... Oh, that's the impugnable class battleship, which was actually used during the Mandalorian Wars, during the used by the Republic. yeah, I gotta take that hangar out. Because they're using... Okay, let me pause this. If you guys don't know, the Impalcable is a Knights of the Old Republic old warship that was used during the Mandalorian Wars against the Mandalorians. And since there was a good majority of the ships actually survived, they were actually used by the Mandalorians after the Mandalorian Wars. So they were still used in service. Up until even to modern day Star Wars, which I guess would be the Clone Wars or Legacy era, they are still used by the Mandalorians.
Awaiting orders.
Barrage.
Attack formation.
So there's everybody's little historical little background on the Impalcable class battleship. That is pretty interesting, though, that Pokemon is actually still around. Due to the fact that ship was used over 3,000 years ago. You would probably think the ship is out of date, but it's not, honest, it's really not. And if you guys don't also know, the Hammerhead is actually still used during the Clone Wars. Not by the Republic, but used by private marketeers as for they're not used as cargo runs. And if you guys like this Let's Play, if you guys like Revan, then like this Let's Play. Like the video down below, because everybody knows Revan. Oh my god, this is taking forever actually. One would imagine that this is going to take quite some time. It's a battleship. It's going to take a bit of time to kill. No, I'm just going to fast forward longer, I don't. This is ridiculous. No battleship should take like 50 bajillion years to destroy, you know, everybody? Where's your health at? Please. Die for the love of all that is holy. Wasn't this music used on the battle, like fighting on the starboard, right? I don't remember what the music was used for actually. Thank you! It only took like 50 bajillion years. Okay guys, now that we got that out of the way.
I've successfully defeated the Mandalorian chieftain. The continuing raids will soon bring them to their knees.
Okay, now what?
Soon after you escaped, I went to recover the artifact from its hiding place.
Jeff was foolish to sell it to the Empire.
Even at twice his price, the Empire would have paid far too little.
I sense you have something to tell me. What is it?
I did gain some information. The artifact dates as far back as the Sith Wars, making it around 4,000 years old. For such an artifact to be so well hidden for so long, it must contain a secret of great importance.
This artifact is 4,000 years old, like the Starforge. But what faction did this artifact belong to?
Based on the design, it is likely a Sith artifact. I believe it may be a data storage device of some kind, but it also seems to serve another unknown purpose.
You're right. This artifact is 4,000 years old. And yes, it is of a Sith design. But the markings on the front and the Kato space coordinates signified in their language, unknown to most. I believe this may be a location of a second Star Forge. This is proven to be quite an interesting find. For now, we we have pressing matters to deal with. Did our informant in prison get the information we needed?
Alrighty. Well,
while I was in prison, one of my cellmates mentioned that the Emperor had a vast collection of treasure that he kept all over the galaxy in hidden vaults. I persuaded him to share more information with me.
So the Emperor's welfare is well protected. Do we know the location of these vaults? Or was your imprisonment a waste of my time?
I never found out, unfortunately. I may have been a bit overzealous in my questioning. He may not have known the locations of the vaults, but I'm convinced his story is more than just a rumor. And now we have the perfect opportunity to test the story, thanks to the Rebels.
The Republic, please continue.
Alliance forces have destroyed the Imperial Death Star over Yavin 4. Most Imperial battle stations carry data pods that are to be ejected during emergencies. Perhaps someone thought to follow protocol before the Death Star was destroyed.
And if the Republic was there, wouldn't they have already discovered the data pods? I do not believe that the Republic would be dumb enough to stay in a place where they are most vulnerable to an open attack.
The Rebels will be there. They have an entire base on Yavin 4 and have nowhere else to go. The Empire will soon send a fleet to retaliate. We must move quickly to find a data pod.
There are a few planets between us and Yavin. What is their fate?
They are none of our concern. If anyone gets in our way, deal with them.
Mission updated. Okay. Let me go ahead and save this right here. Reckoning story. Save. Okay, everybody. So it seems like, if you don't know what that thing means, 4,000 years is during the Great Hyperspace War, which between the Sith Empire and the Republic. But the coordinates of the artifact says it's a second Starforge, which means if Revan gets his hands on that, I'll leave that for later time. What do you guys think will happen when Revan finds the second Starforge? What do you guys think about this all together from this beginning to now? How do you guys feel about it? What do you guys think about it? Let me know what you guys think is going to happen. If you guys enjoyed the video, then hit the thumbs up button. If you want to see more videos than I've done, then click the annotation down below. And if you guys want to see me keep going on with these custom story for the Wrecking Mod, then let me know down in the comments below. Hit that thumbs up button. And as always, everybody, this is Quasar Sueto signing off. Thank you guys for watching, and have a nice day. Bye, guys!
Now, cinematic! And it matches! That is just amazing. It honestly is amazing.